Street today and has the story.
This house was allegedly home to many young boys in this neighborhood of Police Street Extension in Lake Independence. A man in his early 40s has lived here for 2 years, a man who is a registered sex offender, convicted for oral sex with a 14-year-old in California. His neighbors say he didn't talk to them, but they did notice a steady stream of young boys here in this house. It was a cry from one of those youths which caught a neighbor's attention Saturday night.
We was out on the street there when I heard a boy from the neighbor saying that he wanted to go home and things like that. So it brought to my attention. So it came to my attention. I said, what? And that was about 8:30. So I said, what? From there, I saw the little boy came out and he was hiding around the fence over there as if door to see who was around or watching. But I saw him and I picked him up. So I said, what are you doing there? And he said, and he was crying and he said that he wanted to go on and nobody wanted him to go home. So, and he said that the man was having oral sex with him and thing. And he said the guy paid him 2 noodles. So I said, I asked him if his mother knew that he was there, and he said no. So as a result, we called the police.
The police arrived on the scene 15 minutes after, but according to the concerned neighbor who sounded the alarm, they did not do what needed to be done.
When it comes to policing, there is a sequence of events that should transpire when any situation takes place. For example, right now, if there's a shootout out there, you'll see the crime scene come, they will cordon off the place, you'll see them pick up evidence, and same thing should have happened over there. That should have been a crime scene. You understand me? Especially of the nature that it was a kid. So what should have happened that the police, like, since they are not, they were the first responders, but they are not professional in those type of investigation, they should have informed the right people, right? They should have informed the right people, the social, and whoever, as Mr. Chester Williams stated that he had notified. That should have happened the same night. They should have cordoned off the scene, went into the house, look for evidence, look for specimens, look for all the necessary things. You understand me? Look for computer, look for camera, look for all the devices that those type of people use.
None of that was done on Saturday night, apparently, although the alleged predator was detained on the strength of the accusation of the young boy on the scene.
First of all, the police never even have no handcuffs. When they took long to get the man out, because they never did have no handcuff. One of the police asked the other, why you got handcuff? None of them have. You understand me? When they get the guy out, the police came here, you know, to back to the little boy, and they asked each other, what we are doing with this D-boy? I say, carry the bloody boy, Daima. Carry Daima, and you should charge him out too, because he no business out here. That's why I say. And I don't report for that. That's why I tell the police, carry the man, Daima. Anyway, father, they went, they gone.
But the accused returned home shortly after, released from police custody, and that seemed to be the end of that.
So the following day now, when I saw the guy got released, that was what pissed me off. You understand me? Because under no condition that guy should have get released at that time. For example, if the proper investigation would have get done and the proper procedure would have been followed, that wouldn't have happened. You understand me? There's a simple charge that you could put on somebody if since the base by 44, 48. There's a simple charge, harboring a minor. Since there's no evidence yet to the bigger deal, just hold him for harboring a minor then. You have 48 then.
Neighbors tell us that on Wednesday, following the airing of the story on Tuesday night, the alleged pedophile packed up his belongings and seemed ready to run. And that's when he was picked up by police again. 4 days after the incident with the young boy, and only after the media informed the police about it.
Feel somewhere around, you understand? They feel somewhere in another sequence there. Because at all times, the head of the department should be aware they got thing in a police station called Citrip. Like, for example, if something should happen to anyone right now on the headquarters, I know. Chester should have known what took place that night. But he said blatantly on the news that Jules was the one who informed him as the media, he should have been shamed. Honestly, he admitted, and he was grinning on the TV, that Jules, boy, Jules, you informed me, he should have shamed. His department, the department who they should have been the one who informed him. And that was what went wrong.
The neighbor and good Samaritan told us that on Saturday night, just after the alleged offender was detained briefly, two other young boys showed up at his home to hang out. Mike Rodon for News 5.
At news time tonight, no charges have been levied against the alleged predator and registered sex offender. To demonstrate the possible depths of this sickening carnal mess, News 5 was told off the record.